Hallo zusammen, heute werden wir über den Zöller infrarotlich Laserscanner und seine Fähigkeiten und Funktionen sprechen. As you understood, this product was made in Germany. Hi everybody, welcome to our exploration of Zöller infrarotlich Imager 5016. The compact powerhouse transforming the landscape of 3D laser scanning. Join us as we delve into its cutting-edge features and unrivaled capabilities. The Z+F Imager is not just a laser scanner, it's an absolute unit. Let's dive into its dimensions. Compact and lightweight, it's designed to navigate the tightest spaces, fitting into carry-on luggage with ease. Dimensions: usable in smallest spaces. And the weight of this unit is, without batteries, it's 6.5 kilos. And with two batteries inside, it's about 7.5 kilos. With an IP54 protection rating, it's built to withstand the elements from splash water to dust, ensuring reliability in any environment. But what truly sets the Imager apart are its technical features, pushing boundaries with a range from 30 centimeters all the way up to 360 meters, it opens doors to new possibilities and applications. With a maximum measurement rate of over 1 million points per second, this scanner delivers unparalleled accuracy, even over long distances. Its 360 times 320 degree field of view ensures comprehensive coverage, minimizing the need for multiple scan positions. Safety is paramount. Classified as eye-safe under laser class 1, the Imager can be deployed in public areas without restrictions. Equipped with an integrated positioning system, it streamlines real-time registration in field, optimizing efficiency. But it doesn't stop there. The Imager comes equipped with an integrated HDR camera, capturing vibrant color information in just 2 minutes. No external light source is needed, thanks to its integrated LED spots. Data management is a breeze, with internal storage of 128 GB. Transfer data swiftly via SD card, slot, Ethernet connection, or Wi-Fi, ensuring seamless workflow integration. From real-time registration to multi-scanner support, the Imager sets bar high with its advanced laser system, HDR camera, and deflection unit, offering unparalleled accuracy and efficiency. Innovative, efficient, and precise, the Zöller infrarotlich Imager redefines what's possible in 3D laser scanning. Join the revolution today. What's inside the box, you may ask? Well, obviously it's this precious unit, as well as 4 batteries with a charging station, the Ethernet data transfer cable, and user manual, which I suggest you to read before using this scanner. Let's continue watching the video from field to data processing and 3D reconstruction. Danke fürs Zuschauen, thank you for watching, see you in next video. Welcome back. As you can see, the indicator shows that battery is low, so we are going to swap it. First, you need to turn off the scanner. Wait for it to shut down. So now you just pull it out like this and put the charge one inside. And the same thing goes for opposite side. Like this and like this. Now we can go to next location. So we have arrived. Now I just put it back in place so it doesn't fall over. And first thing you need to do, you need to level the tripod. So. So we have leveled the tripod and now we have to level the scanner itself. So let me show you. Here's the main menu. You just press the middle button, press this bubble, and it will show you the position and With these three knobs, you can adjust it so it stays in the green. And for better precision, try to keep it in the middle of the green circle. So this is how it should look like. Now you press 180 degrees. It will turn around, and we will do the same for this. As you can see here, it's almost perfect. We just have to adjust it a little bit. And now we can press back and press this button. And it will show you the menu with settings. You can adjust the resolution, the quality. So here you can see the resolution and the quality. We can adjust it. For example, if you put the resolution down, the scanning time, of course, will be lower. And if you put it up, it will be higher. We are going to use the middle one. And for quality, it's the same. Worse quality, less scanning time, and better quality, more scanning time. We're just using the middle one with the camera, and now we can just go. So the scanning time is 12 minutes for this specific scan, and additional 2 minutes for pictures. We will wait and get back to you. The scan is finished. And we can move to our next location. And we were using scanner's internal software to operate it from the scanner itself, but you can also get a Windows tablet and operate remotely from there. And watch your process and operate from there. Now we're gonna start a new scan and connect to the scanner remotely from computer through its software. So, play. And now we can go. Now we have connected from the computer remotely to the scanner. You can see through the window. And we just press this button, this one. And here we can see all the settings. They are the same as we had before in the scanner itself. Now we just have to press play. The bar on top shows how much of the work is done. And it also shows the battery level. Now if you press this button again, you can press on the web page. And it will also show the progress here. Now we're going to connect through the tablet. The tablet runs on Android operating system. Now we connect to a scanner. Now we just go to the internet and enter the IP address we had on the computer. As you can see, here we can see the progress and status. And you can also operate using the web UI interface. Now, if you want to export data, you open the project folder, select the specific project you need, press this button and this one. Now you can select all your scans, press copy and export it to an SD card. The SD card is located here. And you can remove it easily. Let's head to the computer and explore the data we made. We are back in the office now, and I'm gonna show you data processing using Z+F laser control. Now we press connect. In order to connect to the scanner, we choose LAN. And we connect. When I press this button, I can see that the scanner, the results. This is the precision between the scans. For example, here, the first one is 5 millimeters, and somewhere in between is 9.3 or 10. And this doesn't have anything. And I'm going to show you how to do it, how to calculate the precision. I go to registration and look up for manual scan alignment. Then I load scans. On the first picture, you can see that the scans are not aligned between themselves. One is lower and one is higher. So the scan number 12 is fixed, and the 13th scan is movable. So I just move scan number 13 and align it with the scan number 12. Press OK. And now it should calculate the precision. And our accuracy from this scan is 5.1 millimeters. And now we can see the HDR image of the scan. It's not colored yet. And now we are going to color it. While we're waiting for scan 13 to colorize, we can open scan number 12 and see the color picture already. In the left corner in the preview table, you can see the number of scan, the resolution, quality, and overall picture. This is the colored HDR image. These bubbles show in which positions the scanner was located. And here you can see the actual point cloud of the scan. Now we open scan number 11. And when we open it up, we will see the scan results from the 11th scan. When we press the little camera icon, we can see that the scan had been colored. Scan number 13 has been added, and here you can see the picture on the right. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments, and we will help you. Thank you very much, and goodbye.